This is Ron from Super 8 to Video. This is a three-part series, and this is part one of three, of how to slow a Wolverine Movie Maker film down using Corel VideoStudio Pro. So I'm going to double-click Corel's icon right here to start it up. And this actually takes a minute, so I'm going to skip to the end. Now we're at the end. So what I do is I come up here and do what I call unmaximize this film by clicking on this little box right here. Just left click it once. That brings it down to this state here because that's the last state that I left it in. And what I mean is I can come over here with this mouse and just go right here to the edge. Just hover over it until those double lines appear. See how they appear, disappear, appear, disappear. So I come over here. And then I'm going to left click and hold it, and now I can shrink it down if I want or expand it out if I want. So I'm going to shrink it all the way down to, we'll say, right there, and let go. Now I'm going to close it down to show you VideoStudio Pro will remember this state the next time I start it up, even though I haven't hit save or any of that. So I'm going to close it down. And now I'm going to go restart it, and it's going to start up in the state I just left it in. So I'm double-clicking it again. Again, this takes a minute, so I'm going to skip to the end. Now we're at the end. Okay, now I'm going to come over, hover over here again, grab it, pull it out to here. And I'm going to bring in an 8mm film shot at 16 frames a second. And all you do is bring it down here to what they call the timeline and then let go of the left click. I just held the left click. And this box comes up only the very first time you bring a film in. And it says, do you want to change the project settings to match the video's properties? I always say yes to this. Okay. And now we want to change this speed of this film because it actually plays too fast. And what I mean is, if you watch my dog running around the yard, watch how fast he moves. See how it's playing too quick? So we'll pause this. I come over here to this green area and I double click it. That brings up this area right in here, the color correction, and one of the selections is speed time lapse. So single click this speed time lapse, and this here comes up, and right here where it says speed, I know at 16 frames a second what we want to set it at is 53%. Technically it's 53.3. But VideoStudio Pro won't allow us to do that. It'll allow us to do 53% or 54%, but not 53.3. So I just click in this box, backspace the 100, hit 53. And now if you look right here at this end, see how we can see the end of the film right now? As soon as I hit this OK box, this is going to disappear because the film has become longer. So I go OK. Notice how now we can't see the end of the film. What I do is I come to this little ball here and I left single click and hold it. And now I can move this ball and I move it to the left. And the more left I go, the more unmagnified it becomes. And you can see the film gets more and more to where you can see more and more of the film. So if we had a really long film over here, you'd have to keep moving it further to the left to be able to see it. So we'll kind of re-maximize this up to about there. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring up a WordPerfect document, and it's going to show us the different speeds we need for different types of film. Super 8 film was done in two different speeds. It was either done in 18 frames per second or 24 frames per second. The vast majority of them were done at 18 frames a second. So when it's done at 18 frames per second, you put it at 60%. When it's done at 24 frames per second, you do it at 80%. when it's done at 24 frames per second and you accidentally set it for 60%, what it will do is it will appear to play in slow motion. So therefore, and it's very obvious, you can see it right away. So when that happens, just set it up to 80%. You'll see it'll play at the correct speed. Now, 8mm is a little more tricky because there were a few cameras that filmed at 18 frames per second, but the vast majority did it at 16 frames per second. So you set it at 53% with VideoStudio Pro because it won't allow you to do that 53.3%. I guarantee you, you'll never see the difference between the 0.3% or not. These three right here, the 60%, 80%, and 53%, those were the vast, vast majority of films that were done. But in the 20s, 30s, and 40s, a few films were done at 12 frames a second and 15 frames a second. So just in case you were to run into one of those oddball films, all you do to find the speed is divide the frame rate by 30. So 24 divided by 30 is 80%. 18 divided by 30 is 60%. 16 divided by 30 is 53.3%. But like I say, just set it at 53%. 15 frames a second is 50%, and 12 frames a second is 40%. 8mm was almost always shot at 16 frames per second, but in very rare cases was shot at 18 frames per second. If it seems a little too slow, try 60%, but it is very subtle and not obvious like the 24 frames versus 18 frames. Dave Oldacker, one of my subscribers, asked a good question. Could we figure out what film rate a film was shot at by counting frames per foot? I thought about it, and my answer would be no. A 50-foot roll shot at 18 frames a second would definitely be shorter in time than one shot at 16 frames per second. But still, how would you be able to tell how many still frames per second are supposed to be there without a strobe or some clock reference? I am minimizing WordPerfect. I am now coming over here and starting the dog up again with the 53% change I set earlier. Notice how now the dog is running at normal speed. This is Ron of Super 8 to Video signing off on part 1 of 3. If you want to go to the other videos in this series, all you do is go right up to here, click on it, click on this. This takes you to my webpage. Scroll down a little bit. This, and this you can pretty well ignore, but these blue ones, that's part 1, part 2, part 3. This coming soon is a video on X8, X9, and X10 of VideoStudio Pro. X10 being the latest one, which is April 1st, 2017. This right here, if you click on it, it'll take you to Corel's site at VideoStudio Pro. You can download their latest version, X10, for free and try it for 30 days. This here is if you want an older version. It'll take you to Amazon, and you can buy one of the older versions of Corel Video Studio Pro. Basically, that's it from this point. I'm just going to let it go to the blue screen and let you make your decision.